What is a total fun and effective way to learn Amazon Web Services? It's to get in there, roll up your sleeves, and practice with the technologies. In this nugget, I'll show you just how easy it is to do that. They say that nothing in life is free, but that's not really true because Amazon Web Services has a free tier. And that's what I would want you to Google on if you're interested in practicing with Amazon Web Services and not being charged a dime. Once you do the search AWS free tier, you'll see this link. And when we visit that link, they make it very obvious how we would create our free account. Keep in mind that you are going to need a valid email address in order to create this free account, and you're also going to need a valid credit card. Now, wait a minute here, what's happening? The reason why that credit card is required is twofold. Number one, not everything is free for your 12 months. If we look at the 12 months free tab here on the AWS free tier page, we see things like when it comes to relational database services, it's 750 hours per month of db.t2.micro database usage. If you don't know what any of this means, have no fear. We'll be going through it intensely in this course. But the point is, it's not everything that's free. You could go over within your 12 months the limits that are set up for the free tier. Speaking of always free, there are things that are always free though, so that's pretty cool too. Like storage is free to some extent in Amazon Web Services, as you would guess, since they are competing against free services from Microsoft, from Google, from Dropbox, and from plenty of other free cloud storage systems. Another reason that credit card is required is, remember, if we do 12 months and we're enjoying the free stuff and we're not going over any of this, so it's truly free for us for the 12 months, at the end of that 12 months, we may have infrastructure services still spinning along in the cloud, and Amazon needs to be able to bill us for those services at that time. And Amazon really takes care of us in many places within Amazon Web Services. Notice here on this page where we're choosing an Amazon machine image that there is an option for free tier only, so we can filter this list to make sure we don't inadvertently stumble into some service that would not be with inside that free tier. Now, when we're practicing with Amazon Web Services, there's something else that we can do to make sure that credit card is not inadvertently charged. And that's to do just common sense things like shutting stuff down. So here you can see I actually have a server running. This server, by the way, is an Ubuntu server inside the cloud. Obviously, when I am done practicing with this server, it's going to be a real good idea to right-click the server, go to instance state, and to stop that server. So yes, let's stop that server so that we wouldn't be inadvertently charged. In the demonstrations I do in this course, you'll see me stopping things that we might use again later on, or you'll even see me completely delete the instances and the devices that we're working with, so there can be absolutely no chance we're charged for having that set up inside of our practice environment. But wait a minute here. At some point, we are not going to want to be on the free tier. We're going to be wanting to, you know, bring our real IT infrastructure to the cloud, and we are willing and able to pay for that. In fact, that's one of the whole points of AWS. We can save so much money over traditional ways to implement the infrastructure. Don't worry. I've got a nugget in this course with a great title. It's Monitor and Manage Billing and Cost Optimization Processes. So we'll be taking a close look at how, once you are off of that free tier, how you can make sure you can get the most of your dollar when it comes to spending it inside of Amazon Web Services. Hands-on practice when it comes to Amazon Web Services, no problem for us, thanks to the free tier that is made available. In this nugget, we took a look how easy it would be to sign up for that free tier, and we know exactly why we could incur charges during the free 12 months of the free tier, and of course, what would happen when that free tier does expire at the end of that 12 months. I hope this nugget was informative for you, and I'd like to thank you for viewing.